Hello friends and welcome back. This lecture is in continuation with your lecture series of ATE82D, which is tractors and heavy earth moving machinery, and we are going to discuss about the unit number 2, the special topic or the important topics which are the specific for the exam point of view. Correct. So content for today is the types of hydraulic system. In the previous lecture we discussed about the hydraulic system and its component in respect to your tractor, and today we are going to types of hydraulic systems used in the tractor, methods of attaching implement to the tractor, and hitching system of the tractor, the introduction about the hitching system of the tractor. So I'm going to the first topic, which is the types of hydraulic system. There are three types: position, draft, and mixed control. These are the very important controls in respect to your tractor, because let's say if your front end loader is there and if you wanted to take it to some height, so in that case your position control is very important, so that it should maintain the constant height or the depth of the your implement in a certain height. Correct. So that will be your position control. And which can this position, that every control system, whether it is a position, draft, or your mixed control, it is hydraulically controlled. I would say hydraulically controlled. Correct. So this is very important to know about. Then next is your draft control. Draft control, when you are plowing the field, you are certain at a certain depth, your implement or the harrow or the disc plate should go into the land at a certain depth. How that is to be controlled? That is controlled by the draft control method. So you might have seen in this image, this is the harrow which is going into the land at a certain depth. Somewhere the height is more, somewhere the height is less, but this your draft control system maintain the constant height throughout your field. Correct. So that is the importance of the draft control. Fine. It senses the extra strain on the hitch and allows the plow to raise just enough to get through the hard spot. Let's say while moving through the field or the plowing the field, you might have just strike with a hard spot, so there may be a loss, or maybe a your damage to your harrow or your discs. So in that case the draft control system will sense it and picks up the plowing machine or the implement at a certain up from the depth and then moves the forward here. So it's a draft control which is used in there. But after, when the hard spot is gone, so immediately the your plow will come down and makes the same level of or the same depth which you have selected earlier. That is becoming your draft control. Fine. Then the mixed control. Mixed control is means a desired depth of plowing is maintained within the closed limit. Means mixed control, which is having both the qualities of position as well as draft control. So that is called your mixed control. Fine. How we can get it? A desired depth of plowing is maintained within closed limit. So at a certain limit, in case of a draft, there is no limit. But if you put limits onto the draft, it will become your mixed control. Correct. So both of the qualities are into the mixed control. Then the next topic is attachment and implement. So there's a very close, there's a thin line difference between the attachment and the implement. Implement is called any article used in some activity, especially on instrument, tool, agriculture, implement like harrow or a disc. Then attachment, and additional or supplementary device attached for a tractor. Correct. So article which is completely depending upon the tractor, and additional supplementary device which is attached meant for a tractor. Correct. Which is also onto the tractor. So could be something such as a front end loader or front end loader, FEL we call it, as a trailer or a hitch bar becoming your attachments. Fine. So there's a two different, there's a very thin line difference between attachment and implement. So this is kind of your attachments and implement which we are used onto the tractors. Correct. Different attachment and implements. Fine. Yeah, this is your front end loader. Like your, this height is to be maintained with your position control system. The depth or the draft is controlled using this one. So both are the control system used for, yeah. This is the cylinders which are hydraulically controlled. So this whole thing is controlled hydraulically. Then the next is methods of attaching implements. So there are three types of implement which we are using, but in India we are just using two types, the first and the last one, the mounted type. So the three types: trailed type implement, semi-mounted type implement, and mounted type implement. So what are the trailed implements? As from the image you might have seen that there's a trailed implement, those attachments which are having their own wheels and carry their own loads, they're becoming the trailed. correct? Attachment of the tractor drawbar, and this cannot be raised or lowered. This cannot be raised, but nowadays we can do it. Implement trail the tractor as it moves. So it is having its own tires and it is carrying its own load onto it. Although it is tracted or the pulled by the tractor, but carrying its own load is completely onto its tires. Fine, that is called your trailed type. Then we are having a semi-mounted. Semi-mounted means which is some part of it is mounted on the tractor, means some load is carried by the tractor and some load is carried by the tires or the wheels. Correct. So those are called your semi-mounted type. So it is called a seed drill, which is not completely depending on tractor and not completely on the tire. As you can see in here, there's a one tire, or maybe two tires are over there. They're not completely carrying its load, but yes, some of the load is carried by the tractor and some of the weight, I would say. Some of the weight is carried by the tractor, some of the weight is carried by the tires. So that becomes your semi-mounted. And the third one is completely mounted. Those kind of attachment which are, their load is completely mounted onto the tractor chassis, that becomes your mounted implement. It can be mounted on the 3-point hitch system, whether we are having the 2-point hitch system or a single point hitch system, but best or today's very much advantageous or useful method is a 3-point hitch system, 3-point hitch linkage, from where the attachment is to be attached with the tractor with these 3 points. That's why it is called 3-point hitch system. It is why it is advantageous, we'll discuss in the next lecture, but yes, it is very advantageous, correct? So there's a 3-point, as we can see, the single point hitch system, which is a trailer type, which you can pull, correct? 2-point hitch system, which is semi-mounted type, we generally say it, and a 3-point hitch system, which is moved completely onto the whose load is completely onto the tractor. So this is a 3-point hitch system, if you can see here, the 3-point hitch system over there. There's a top view and the front view or the side view, you can say. Here the horizontal convergence. So this is 1, this is 2, and beyond there's a 3-point. Fine. So there's a 3-point hitching system in there. Here implement can be hitched in 2 ways. So as I told you, we use either single point or 3-point. The 2-point linkages in India is very less to use. Correct. And now technology has been changed. So maximum things are to be attached like 3-point linkage, correct? So the drawbar hitch system, you might have seen in the back of the tractor, this kind of a bar is there, correct? You can adjust the length of this bar, and this is like your trailer is attached with this through a hook, correct? And that is becoming your drawbar, correct? This does not allow to rotate in any direction. Yeah, this is very much important. This does not allow to rotate in any direction, but yes, it is used to pull. And even this drawbar cannot move up and down. Whether you can change the location of the drawbar to given locations over there, but this cannot move, this cannot let the trailer rotate in any direction. Fine, this is drawbar hitch system. Then the 3-point linkages, as I discussed earlier, 1, 2, and 3-point, correct? So the 3-point linkages system is used there. It's a combination of 3 links. One is upper link, one this one, and the 2 are the lower links. These 2 are the lower links, correct? So this is called your 3-point linkage. Fine, what are the advantages of the 3-point linkage system? There's easy to control, quick setting of the implement, automatic hydraulic control of the implement, such as position control and draft control, which is discussed earlier. Good balancing of the attached implement. That is actually the best advantage, the good balancing. Correct. When it is a single, if you have already drive a tractor, you might be knowing that what is the balancing problem while you are pulling up the trailer or while you are pulling any attachment which is 3-point hitch. There's a good balancing. Your load is distributed on the tractor chassis equally, homogeneously, so that it should remain in the balance. There's a very less chances that your trailer would get rollover, correct? Or maybe your tractor would get rollover. Very well. So what is the hitching system? Unless properly hitched, it cannot give the best performance. The very first step is, if your trailer or maybe any implement, it is not attached onto the tractor where it is required or where it is best suited, so you cannot increase the performance. Even your performance of your tractor would get decreased. So the primary objective of proper hitching of pull type implement having adjustable pull members is to establish location or magnitude of the resultant parasitic support. What does this mean is, you might have seen this case. So this can be easily understood, this example. So this drawbar pull, if it is only one single point is here for the pulling of every implement, so why they have provided these holes in here, correct? The holes which are attached with this, why these are provided? Because you can change as per your implement weight, as per your the balancing of your implement, you can change the location of the drawbar to any point, correct, to any location. So in that case, the proper hitching system is required. That primary objective is to pull time implement having adjustable pull members. So the pull members are adjustable and the location can be changed so that you can get the best performance out of your tractor. That is the use of hitching system, correct? And that will be discussed in the next lecture. And today, if you wanted to see my previous videos or further lectures, you must subscribe this Tiny Step channel and watch the video and share the video. This might help someone else who's get stuck in this lockdown. Fine. Thank you and take care.